Got a beer here from Mad Hatter, and it's the Stocky Stout. Apparently it's a take on an old ale, a stock ale, which was known back then. And basically it's a way of blending medium to dark beers. I forgot to do the research for this, so I've just been past 10 minutes, 15 minutes, just finished work, and reading up as quick as I could, because I really wanted a beer. I had this in mind, and I just forgot to do the information. But yeah, so all that's out there is, so it's an old ale, but they've also blended some bananas in there, yes. It's a beer with bananas, actual bananas. Yeah, it actually says it. And it's also got lactose, so 5.3%. It's brewed from Liverpool. Mad Hatter. I've had a few of their beers. Some good, some not so good. But I was in Huddersfield visiting a new bottle shop, Arcade Beers, and the guy behind the counter recommended this, so I took him on his recommendation. He says it's like a sour stout. And I'm just looking on Untapped, because it's not even on Red Beer, this beer. So I was looking on Untapped. Sometimes they have more information. And on there, they compare it to a roasty but sour stout with bananas. Like those little foam bananas that you would have as a kid, which I enjoyed as a kid. Definitely pick up that sourness. Slight bit of black pepper, a little bit of almost like a root beer, like a sarsaparilla. There's a little bit of dark pepper. If you dive further in, I can see what they mean by those little foam bananas. But this has actually got real bananas. Slight creaminess. It reminds me slightly of when I used to get a milkshake as a kid at a local market. They'd blend ice cream and bananas and all kinds of stuff. And it was really nice. And it's gone now, but that's what it reminds me of. There's a slight bit of like dark currants, like a little bit of dates. That's what I'm thinking of, dates, not currants. Anyway, cheers. Very complex on the aroma. Oh my god! Right, starts off. You get that nice creamy milk stout, sort of. And then it hits you like a really dry sharpness and a little bit of funky banana. It's like, so I saw this on Tap as well. It's like drinking a nice stout, and all of a sudden you get like a backwash of like someone's dropped. You know, when you have like a beer float, and you blend ice cream with beer. It's like you get a little bit of that gloopy ice cream in it, because it's shit at the back. It's like dryness on the back as well, which is off-putting a bit. That's why I went shocked. you get past the initial shock and taste, because you get a really nice stout there. And they mentioned that on the side. They've done a really nice stout, but they've changed it up a bit with adding bananas. I'm starting to enjoy it a little more. I can see why the guy from RKB has recommended it. It's just slightly off-putting. It's not as sour as you think it would be. It's the way everybody's been trying to sour. I had a beer from Norway, Nognio, the Strandog. That was tart and sour and dry. This isn't as much. It's just the initial taste is kind of shocking, because you look at it and you think, no, it's fine. But I think the banana actually helps a little bit, because it adds a little bit of body, otherwise it would be a little bit more one-sided. Yeah, so the more I'm drinking it, the more I appreciate it. Thank you to the guy from Arcade Beers, which is where I purchased this from. Definitely check it out if you're in Huddersfield. But if you like being surprised, Stocky Stout. There's a slight nuttiness on the back as well. But anyway, you take care.